All right, I have an urgent news report. I have discovered that I am allergic to mangoes. Oh my gosh. I have tried. I've been eating them as part of my mono diet, my mono meal. And I noticed like immediately, like the first, the second, the third day that I was having this puffy lip, upper lip just got real puffy. And I'm like, well, what's the deal? And then I look it up, and then it ends up being the skins of mango. The skins are very, very poisonous. And I did that very day, on one of those days, I ate a little bit of the skin by accident. And it never supposed to. And unfortunately, when the preparation of the mango, when you are scraping the fruit from the skin, it ends up on your board. The actual skin is on your board. It's everywhere. And so, anyway, so it's turned me into like this extra large upper lip. And it's very, very annoying because I really like mangoes. And I don't know how I'm going to do this because the vegan diet really, really, really is heavy with mangoes. You know what I mean? Heavy with mangoes, so I'm not sure the tropical fruit replacement, how I'm gonna get something that is equal in status. But yeah, this is a major news alert. I really tried. I've even like, you know, force fed myself the mangoes regardless, hoping that I was going to develop an immunity to it and wear it off, but thus far nothing. I'm still gonna continue doing that though for a few more weeks. I'll let you know if the puffiness goes away. But a big shock. Apparently it is an anaphylactic, similar to a spider bite. It's very poisonous, and I can't believe this. I just can't believe this, because I'm not allergic to anything. Not allergic to a thing. And then all of a sudden, these poor little mangoes, which are so wonderful, in the vegan diet. Anyway, on the other house jurisdiction duties. Oh my gosh! I put white appliance epoxy on the kitchen sink, because it's like the day that I moved into this house, the white sink was all of a sudden damaged. So I'm like, well, I guess I have to repair that. And so it was one of those, like, you know, you move in and it's just like, uh-oh, how did that happen? So I went for this epoxy. It's like an appliance epoxy. And it went up my nose, okay? So it paints your nose hairs. If anybody wants their nose hairs painted white, go for it that way. But it's awful to try to clean out, because I don't even have nail polish remover, and I didn't want to stick that up my nose. But it really does a spray paint up there, okay? And I imagine the same goes with the clear creolin. Now, I use that, you know, your basic creolin and your Rust-Oleums, and they're great, but, and I used also today, I used that same appliance when on the toilet. Now, we will see if it works. I have a terrible toilet that also showed up that just wasn't quite any longer. It's like the day I moved in, the toilet decided to turn another color. So everything just like fell apart in those porcelains. And so I'm trying this other one. It's a Rust-Oleum appliance only, because I cannot find one for porcelain specific. They don't seem to sell it. And I'm not sure what that's all about. And this does say that it's water resistant, but I mean, I'm talking the toilet bowl, so it's going to be sitting in water. So it's a big problem, isn't it? That because you don't want to have to replace the whole bowl just because of stains that and there's stains that of the porcelain when you clean the porcelain actually gets scratches on it, and then it discolors, and then the original porcelain paint is gone. So yeah, and then also I'm into my creolin. I love the creolin. too much maybe. No, I love aquilin, and I'm for some planters. So I'm spray painting these planter wires, and so today is a spray paint day in the midst of a mango allergy. So this is a news alert to my family members, because we very may well all have it. Very, very much so. Okay? Yeah.